그래서 그 구절에 보면 만약 우리가 사람의 증언을 받을진대 하나님의 증거는 더욱 크도다. 이건 하나님의 증거라는 거예요. 너희가 선지자를 통해서 사람의 증거를 받잖아요. 이건 하나님의 증거. 성령과 물과 피. 그 피가 살아있다는 거예요. 파라오의 미라에서 나오는 피는 절대로 염색체를 채취할 수가 없습니다. 그런데 2000년 동안 예수의 피는 살아있다 이거예요. 동정녀에서만 나오는 여자 그 남자와 상관없는 뭐 동정녀에게만 나올 수 있는 염색체만 나오는 거예요. 이게 또 증거 아니겠습니까? 자, 그래서 이 천사들을 만나고 무지개가 그 법궤에 펼쳐져 있는 그 과정에서 그론 화이트의 간증을 잠깐.
Chapter 5, verses 8 and 9. It says, There are three that bear witness in earth, not in the earth, but in earth, meaning under the ground, the spirit, the water, and the blood. And these three agree in one. Then, verse 9, it says, If we receive the witness of man, the witness of God is greater. And this, speaking of the blood and the water presented to our hearts and minds through the power of the Holy Spirit. This is the Father's witness and testimony of his Son. Now in a court trial, a witness gives a testimony. That testimony becomes evidence or proof. Right? So what this is saying in our language of today is that the blood and water on the mercy seat of the Ark of the Covenant, the earthly throne of the living God, is the Father's proof to the inhabitants of this world that his Son has indeed died for us, that we have been redeemed, and that we can come to him in the name and blood of his Son, receive forgiveness and restoration, so that one day, as recorded in the 22nd chapter, 14th verse of the book of Revelation, It says, Blessed are they that do his commandments, that they might have a right to the tree of life and may enter in through the gates into the city. The payment, dear friends, has been made. And in God's appointed time, you will be able to see the proof for yourself. I believe the Ark of the Covenant will stay right where it is throughout eternity. It is God the Father's proof to the inhabitants of this earth that his son died for us. Now, there are some things that are going to happen in the future that will involve 144,000 getting to see that. All right? And it's not according to a lot of people's stories about the millennium and all. Folks, I'll have to tell you this. Nothing is going to happen like the majority of people believe it's going to. The Bible says, run not after a multitude to do evil. It says, wide, broad is the gate, or wide is the gate, broad is the way that leads to destruction. Many go in there, straight is the gate, narrow the way that leads to life everlasting.
14만 4천이 보게 될 거라고 저는 믿습니다. 이방인 교회 시대가 끝나면 이스라엘의 시대가 다시 오는 겁니다. 이방의 교회 신부들이 휴거가 될 겁니다. 그리고 나면 어떤 일이 벌어질까요? 나팔이 불려지게 되죠. 일곱 나팔, 세븐 트럼펫이죠. 첫 번째 나팔, 두 번째 나팔. 예, 이것은 재앙의 시작이죠. 심판입니다. 배도한 자들에 대한 심판. 믿지 않는 무신론자들에 대한 심판입니다. 그 심판은 지구의 인구 3분의 1이 죽는 것으로 시작합니다. 어부의 시대가 지나면 사냥꾼의 시대가 와서 전부 다 반유대주의가 일어나서 전 세계에는 모든 유대인들이 다 이스라엘로 집결시킬 겁니다. 그리고 나서 어떤 일이 벌어지겠습니까? 저 그리스도는 이스라엘을 없애보려고 하지만 이스라엘이 전쟁에 승리하게 되죠. 이제 전쟁에 승리하게 되기 때문에 중동의 패권을 갖게 됩니다. 그러니까 에스겔을 보면 이란, 소련, 러시아부터 시작해서 대장으로 다달라부터도 예, 모든 모슬렘 연합이 이스라엘을 공격한다고 나옵니다. 그때 이스라엘의 승리가 되죠. 그러면 이스라엘은 중동의 패권 국가가 되는 겁니다. 누구도 이스라엘을 건드릴 수가 없어. 그러니까 협상을 하는 거죠. 협상은 대등해야 하는 겁니다. 이해되시죠? 그러면서 성전을 지어주겠다는 얘기가 나오겠죠. 그러면서 14만 4천과 두 증인이 이스라엘에서 활동을 하게 됩니다. 그때가 전 3년 반입니다. 휴거가 있은 후에 전 3년 반 동안 이제 그들이 복음을 전할 때 민족적인 회개가 있을 거라고 스가랴 12장에 말하고 있습니다. 우리가 그를 찔렀고 증거가 있을 거 아닙니까? 증거가. 그래서 요한일서에 뭐예요? 성령과 물과 피가 땅 아래서 하나님이 증거하신다는 거예요. 이게 공개될 거라고 저는 봅니다. 이 법궤가 공개되고 이 사실이 공개되면서 이제야 우리가 이 메시아를 찾았다. 2000년 전 죽은 십자가에 매달리신 피 흘리신 그분이 메시아요. 그 피에 보혈의 피가 우리 죄를 속한다 하면서 회개하게 이르게 되는 거야. 마지막 영상을 보겠습니다.
Now, when Christ died and the earth shook and the rocks were rent, a crack came right down the entire face of the escarpment, right past the left side of the cross hole, and the stone opened up. Down below, 20 feet below, God had arranged for the Ark of the Covenant with its mercy seat, if you please, his earthly throne, to be positioned right down there 600 years before in 586 B.C. when the Babylonian army destroyed the city. When the centurion stuck his spear in Christ's spleen and probably left ventricle to make sure he was dead before he gave the body to Joseph of Arimathea, when he pulled that spear out, the separated platelets and serum of the blood of the Son of God gushed out, went down through that crack onto the mercy seat, and that ratified the old covenant and the new covenant. The fourth trip I made into this chamber, it was spotless. The furnishings were set in perfect order. The Ark of the Covenant, however, had been placed against the wall, the end of the cave. The end of the cave was a beautiful crystal radiating the colors of the rainbow. Now, I know New Age and all that goes in for rainbows, so the homosexuals and all of that. But God used it first, all right? It's around his throne. And it's around his earthly throne. Now, there's no veil in this setup. So it is the earthly, it's God's temple on earth, or his residence where he once dwelt. And anyway, when I found it like this, there were four young men standing in there. And I started to say, you know, what are you doing here? And I froze. I couldn't move, couldn't breathe, couldn't do anything. One of the people said, we are the four angels that have been taking care of the ark since Moses put the tables of stone in it, right? And they instructed me to set up my video camera with the tripod and aim it at the Ark of the Covenant. And they went over, lifted the mercy seat up. I don't know how heavy it is. I've never tried to lift it, but it's solid gold. And the angel said, take the tables of stone out of there. God wants everyone to see those. I took them out, all right? They put the mercy seat back down over the Ark of the Covenant. I backed away a little bit. The angel came, got the tables of stone, put them on a rock ledge inside the chamber. And I was then instructed to take a sample of the blood from the mercy seat, have that analyzed, and I did everything the angel told me to do. Real quickly, okay, dried blood is dead blood. Everybody knows that, all right? They can test the blood of the pharaohs, the mummies of the pharaohs, all right? There's certain things they can do. They cannot get a chromosome count by any method I'm familiar with, all right? Things keep changing. I don't profess to know everything. However, there's no way I know that you can get a chromosome count out of dead blood. chromosome count, all right? That's done by living white blood cells. Now then, first of all, in this analysis, I took the blood into a laboratory in Israel. I asked one of the people I work with in antiquities, where is a good laboratory that does reliable work? And they said, such and such, such and such. I took it. I just said, please examine this blood and tell me what you can tell me about it, all right? They said, well, look, we're going to reconstitute it. We're going to put it in normal saline and keep it at body temperature for 72 hours with gentle swirling, all right? That's their business. That's great. I said, now, I want to be there when you check it out. They said, fine. So I was back. They checked it out. I said, now, they said, it's human blood. We can tell that. They did whatever tests they need to do. And then I said, take some of the white blood cells and put them in a growth medium and keep them at body temperature for 48 hours. And they said, well, that'll do no good because it's dead blood. I said, would you please do that for me? And they said, okay, we'll do it. So anyway, I said, I want to be there when you take it out and examine it. So I was back there. They took it out, examined it under a microscope, and the one technician called the other one over there, and then they called the boss over there, and they were talking Hebrew a mile a minute there for a little bit, and they looked at me and they said, Mr. Wyatt, this human blood only has 24 chromosomes in it. Everybody else has 46. You see, 23 from your mother, 23 from your father, 22 autosomes from your mother, 22 autosomes from your father. You get an X from your mother, you may get an X or a Y from your father, all right? This blood had 23 chromosomes from the mother's side, one Y chromosome only. You see, the child could not have developed if they hadn't had the autosomes from the mother. So all of his physical characteristics were determined by his mother's side of the family, her autosomes. His maleness was determined by this one Y that came from the source, not a human male. Then they said, this blood is alive. And then they said, whose blood is this? I said, it's the blood of your Messiah.